that this year families were going to be more important than ever to be connected to what their students were doing. About a third of our students started the year learning at home remotely. And so families needed to be intimately tied into the learning that was happening and how they could best support their learners. And if you were dropping your student off or they were riding the bus, you also needed to know what was going on there in a way that was maybe deeper and more critical than ever before. Yeah. Students were in cohorts and they were in these unusual schedules. And so we asked our teachers to contact families 6 times throughout the year, kind of at key moments. And we told them what they should be talking about in each of those 6 times. So call number 1 is really relationship building. Call number 2, which happened during this window, was going to be around technical support and making sure students had launched successfully into the year and what the foundational academic practices were going to be to connect. Call 3 was like by the end of the first quarter. And so it was around how your student has done so far and what their assessment data was showing, et cetera, et cetera. And so this was something that we had never done before in a meaningful way. And so it was big to put a lot of emphasis on family engagement. If you were a remote teacher, you may have suddenly had 200 students that you're working with when you're used to working with 70. And if you're an in-person teacher, your class has now been limited to 20-to-1 max, and many of them had 14 or 15. And so it's now 14 or 15, not a big deal. 180, whatever the number is a totally different story. And so we spent the first 6 weeks of the school year battling about when these calls were gonna happen, what was gonna be cut from the schedule so they could make the calls happen, how the script was gonna work. Did a text count? Did it have to be a phone call? Could it be an email? What was the exact format? Where do you record it in the student information system? So a lot of pushback around pulling this off, even though it was such a pronounced priority for us and we knew it was gonna pay dividends. But at this point, we ended up reducing it from 6 to 4. We ended up lengthening the windows. We ended up broadening the way communication counts, but we still got there. No one disliked the family engagement calls. No one thought it was a bad idea. No one thought it wouldn't be better for kids. But it's the technical side of how you find time to that. I mean, I absolutely think we should continue family engagement. I think we should keep it narrow and focused and really targeted so that we've defined the time you're going to do it. You're going to have this Friday afternoon off for 3 hours. You can do the call. It'll be roughly with the script. And I think the muscle has been built enough where people could work with that. We probably shouldn't do 6 or 10 or whatever the original number could be. But it's just a good practice no matter what. That's equitable for families and kids. Particularly at elementary and middle school, teachers reported things like, I've never really had this deep of a connection with families before. I didn't know that in Somali families, this particular thing is a custom and this is how I can work with a student when they're here. I didn't understand that a family could really help read to their kid every night if I gave them just a little more guidance.